You have an interview to attend. On this tutorial, we have come up with some of the frequent asked civil engineering interview questions along with their answers. Generally, in an interview, the employer will ask civil questions with simple answers to test their basic knowledge and understanding of civil engineering. If you yourself are appearing for it, you don't need to worry so much about interview and focus on the basics. Rest and know that one thing you learn in the training once you get the selected job, because it's not all things that you know, so you just need to focus on what you are going to answer. So this tutorial is going to be very helpful. We are going to look at those questions. And kindly, if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment. Question number one, what are the steps involved in the concreting process? So the steps are involved in the concreting process are batching. Batching, this is where we weigh the aggregates that we are going to use, and then mixing, and then we have transporting and placing, and then we have compaction. Question two, what is the difference between one-way slab and two-way slab? One-way slab, ratio of longer span over shorter span is less than two. And then two-way slab, when the ratio of the longer span over the shorter span is more than or equal to two. Question number three, what do you mean by segregation? Segregation is the separation of cement sand from aggregate. This is caused due to water cement ratio and when concrete is poured about more than 1.5 meters. Question four, what is soil analysis? Soil analysis is the testing of the soil to determine the nutritional and elemental composition of the soil. It is generally tested for knowing the content of the nitrogen, potassium, and phosphorus. Question five, what is bending moment and shear force? Bending moment is the reaction induced in a structural element when an external force or moment is applied to the element, causing the element to bend. The most common or simplest structural element subjected to bending moment is the beam. Shear force is the force in the beam acting perpendicular to its longitudinal axis. For design purposes, the beam's ability to resist shear force is more important than its ability to resist the axial force. Axial force is the force in the beam acting parallel to the longitudinal axis. Question six, what is water cement ratio and how is it related to the strength of concrete? Water cement ratio is the ratio of the weight of water to the weight of cement used in a concrete mix. A lower ratio leads to higher strength and durability, but may make the mix difficult to work. That is, low workability of concrete mix. Workability can be increased with the use of admixtures. Question seven, what are the responsibility of a construction manager? The responsibility of a construction manager are cost estimates, pre-purchase of selected materials, selection of bidders for bidding phase, analysis of proposals, construction contracts negotiation, construction scheduling and monitoring, cost control of construction, construction supervision. Number eight, what is the recommended slump for column? The recommended slump for column is 75 to 125 millimeters. What is the initial and final setting time of ideal cement mix? The initial setting time for ideal cement mix is around 30 minutes for almost all kind of cement. For masonry cement, it can be 90 minutes. Final setting time for ideal cement mix should be 10 hours at maximum. For masonry cement, it shouldn't exceed 24 hours. Question 10, what is the volume of a 50 kg bag of cement? The volume of a 50 kg bag of cement is 0.035 cubic meters. Question 11, describe the various methods of concrete curing. The process of maintaining the moisture and temperature condition for freshly deployed concrete is referred as curing. It allows the hardening of the concrete. The method involved in the process are spraying of water, ponding, wet covering of the surface, steam curing, application of curing compound. Question 12. Explain the reinforcements that are used in the process of pre-stressing. We have spalling reinforcement. It is used to reduce the stress that forms behind the loaded areas of the anchor blocks, thus reducing the chances of fracture of the concrete at the surface. We have the bursting reinforcement. At times, stress transactors are conveyed in the line of action of load. This can lead to a fracture. To reduce this, bursting reinforcement are used. Equilibrium reinforcement, it is used in those cases where several anchorage exists. Question 13, what is civil engineering? This is a very common question, and as you proceed to your interview, you should be able to answer this perfectly well. Civil engineering is a professional engineering discipline that works in the design, construction, maintenance of the physical and natural built environment, including public works such as roads, canals, bridges, dams, airport, sewerage system, pipeline, structural components of buildings and railways, among other things. So this answer is not so specific. You can elaborate on your own understanding of civil engineering. And then we proceed to the next question. Describe the various types of slam test indication. Slam tests are initiated to empirically measure the consistency of fresh concrete before it sets. They can also be used to check for an improperly mixed batch of concrete as well. There are three different types of slams that occur in slam test as listed below. We have the true slam, the shear slam, and the collapse slam. We proceed to the last question. What do you mean by moment of inertia? A quantity expressing a body's tendency to resist angular acceleration, which is the sum of the product of the mass of each particle in the body with the square of its distance from an axis of rotation. So guys, that is how, those are kind of some of the questions that you expect in your interview. Until next time, bye-bye.